Hi Virgo, this is your next 10 days reading. I'm going to take the date of 3rd of December to the 12th of December. I'm going to look at this time period for you to understand what energies are coming for the collective of Virgo, Sun, Moon and Rising sign. What is influencing you in this time period? So the influences of are of harmony, of some kind of soulmate situation, friendship, love, good sibling relationship, old situations coming back, but this is also about support and recognition in this time period. So something harmonious is going to influence you in this time period, whether whatever you are going through, Virgo, whether it is a setback in your life, whether it is a sense of betrayal, whether it is a difficulty of some sort or a sticky situation, what is coming to you is a help, support, friendship, recognition of your talents, getting into a new situation, something which you will be accomplishing. You will get into that. So there could be also an ex coming back in this time period. So the devil and the justice here tells us that you could be tied to someone. It could be a partnership, it could be a job, it could be comfort levels, but it is becoming toxic in your life, or there are situations because of the stickiness of the situations, things are not moving. So there you may have hit a block in the past, just the recent past, but justice is coming to you, and justice means that there will be, you know, something which will come to your defense. It will bring equilibrium in your life. So in a situation of block 2 and 2, so you might be seeing 2 and 2 and 2, you know, a lot of twos in this time period, 2 2 2. So basically you are moving towards the influences of 3. So basically 3 is coming along, and 3 is the number of protection and support. So with 2 of Pentacles you are doing fine. Nothing is getting, like, there is no problem as such, but there is a conflict. There is a conflict and you are juggling. You might be juggling 2 things, might be juggling 2 relationships, might be getting stuck in a situation where you have to struggle very hard. With the 2 of Swords, nothing is changing. There could be blocks in terms of relationship. This means that somehow you are tugging along. There could be a partner who is not showing you enough reciprocation, or there is ego fight going on. Someone does not fulfill you, maybe. With the 2 of Cups, what is happening is renewal of these energies will take place. There will be a sense of balance coming back in your life, a renewal coming back in your life that is connected with your 10 of Pentacles. So 10 of Pentacles and renewal and a new beginning means a job opportunity, talks about a new job, breakthroughs in partnership is coming in for you. Something had become very sticky and toxic, so that was giving you a sense of sadness. 5 of Cups, so you were feeling very sad, but with the Hermit card and the King of Cups card, also some of you have gone through separation and that separation is not changing, but with the Hermit card, which is also endorsing your energy, it is telling me that you will be able to figure out your next step, because you will have the wisdom of the Hermit and you are going to draw upon that to, you know, have a stalemate removed from your path, have a block removed from your path. So with the Lovers card and the Strength card, you could be having a strong partnership. You will be having your strength of character to break through. in a love situation and also breakthrough in a career situation. However, you have the Four of Wands as your obstacle. So Four of Wands obstacle is sometimes you could be choosing comfort, you could be choosing status quo, you could be choosing things that are familiar, but angels are telling you to show some strength of character to move towards something new. It is asking you to take chances and move beyond your current situation. Some of you need to, you know, make a move. Some of you have to move on from situations that are sticky. However, you have to, you will have choice. Some of you will have choice regarding a job. Some of you will have a new job coming in and an old job. You have to decide between the two. Some of you have to choose a new partner in this time period, or you know, show some strength or courage or patience in terms of your relationship or a relationship choice. So some of you will stay back in the old, some of you will make a choice to move forward and move on from things that betrayed you, things that kept you stuck in situations. And in the next 10 days I am seeing maybe a journey happening, maybe a rite to safe passage happening. You are being guided towards a moving on in this time period. Don't get checked by the Four of Wands, that is wanting to keep to the familiar situation. So you are being asked to close a chapter in your life regarding your misery, and it will be an easy choice with the Lovers and the Strength. It will be an easy choice. You will get the power to deal with a dual situation in your life, and the misery that you are feeling, a chapter will be closed over that. So basically you will have to make the easy choice in your life and move away from situations of misery. If you were feeling sensitive about situations where people were treating you with less respect, or they were ignoring you, or if they were not giving you what you wanted, you have to just make the correct choice and the easy one and move away. So a choice for yourself has to be made in this time period. And because some of you are living a hard life because of someone else, you could be living a difficult situation because of someone else. So in this time period, look at yourself, what you require, and make that choice, and you know, close that chapter of insensitive people around you, insensitive workplace. So you have to just, you know, muster up some courage and make that decision. And you are being guided by forces in this time period to make this decision. You are in Nine of Pentacles. You don't have to worry about others. If you are worrying about others, you will see that you have a challenging financial situation. But if you stop taking their cross on your shoulders, you will see that you are doing well and you have enough. So Ten of Swords is telling me a situation is coming to an end. It is a difficult ending. It is an ending where people were not good to you. They were not treating you well. A relationship was not good. You are not, you don't require anything. You are just not letting a situation go because you don't want to tip the apple cart. But what I am seeing is Ace of Wands and Ace of Swords. This is, you know, realization, epiphany will come to you. You will find that path in difficulty, in chaos, in a difficult you know, scenario, or some block or on your mind, you know, illusions. You know, you have to see this card. This is Two of Swords with the a band over your eyes. Your eyes are being someone is not letting you open your eyes. Someone could be very stubborn. Someone is creating a block you know, in front of you, and you are in an illusion that if you break this you know, stalemate, what will happen is something bad for you. But let me tell you, you will realize in this time period, with the strength of your character, that in this chaos there can be victory. Your path is difficult, but you will choose a situation, and with the Ace of Wands and Ace of Swords, things will become clear. Life spirit will come back to you. Sticky situations will move away. Make that easy choice. So some of you are also going to look at yourself finally. And with the Ace of Cups, Ace of Wands and Ace of Swords, what a beautiful reading. It is telling us that a new beginning is coming up, and you have to choose that. And you can feel self-love, you can recognize yourself in this time period, recognize your worth in this time period, and it is asking you to train your eyes towards yourself and choose what suits you. And with the Knight of Wands and the King of Pentacles, you are going to choose to move towards someone with passion. You could be moving towards a place or a choice of your transfer. You could be taking a transfer. You could be taking a trip. You could be going for a vacation. You are going to take an action that will, you know, break this, you know, bomb this, you know, energy of stalemate, or the 222 which is coming to you. Some 222 tells us that there is a barrier. There is a difficulty, there is a duality in which you are being guided to make a choice for yourself. With the King of Pentacles, you are very practical, you are very you know, secure in your profession or in your relationship. You can take a chance to move forward and move towards what interests you in this time period. Your outcome is telling me that with the Three of Pentacles, people will collaborate, people will support, there will be recognition of your talent. So some of you need to move forward with your talent and do not remain in a situation that is not recognizing your talent. So in your work, you need to understand what is important to you, what will interest you, what do you want and where do you want to go. So you are going to achieve that, and in a new situation you are going to achieve some success. So you know, you have to move towards that. Intuitively, something will end for you with the High Priestess and the Death card. So a great transformation is happening within. And with the Eight of Pentacles, you could be taking up a new training, you could be moving towards a new talent, you could be taking up a new job, and efforts will have to be done. You will have to do efforts in this time period, and you are going to, you know, redesign, rethink and rework on situations and leave what is not suiting you at all. So some of you are making this move within the 10 days, and let's read out the card that is most important for you. This is the advice card from Angels and Ancestors deck. So the Spirit Fox card is coming for you. So it is asking you to trust your talents in changing times. So stay alert as changes in the air. So the Spirit Fox features the favorite animal of our times, the red fox, an amazingly you know, resilient creature, able to survive in different conditions, whether it is a you know, temperatures of the Arctic, or whether it is any other situations that are freezing. So know what it's like to be buried or hunted. For centuries they have been sought for their precious fur, when all they want is to survive. So The energies around you are changing at this time, and although it may not always be comfortable, you are equipped with all that you need to survive this shift. There is a shift which is coming in. You are being presented with opportunities to reach spaces you have never encountered before, and this can make you feel on the edge, but be open to shifts occurring because they really are the answers to your prayers. So the experience of being hunted or threatened is now behind you, and you are being invited to come out from your den and reveal your glory and talents. Call upon your spirit fox medicine to help you be seen for who you are, and trust in your talents in order to be the best you can be in these changing times. So this is what I have for you. Definitely intuitive transformation is happening. You are not ready to accept how it was in the past. So with the Eight of Pentacles, you are honing your talent, you are working on your craft, you are making efforts to do things with great concentration, and you are going to move towards your passion, towards what interests you and how you want to live your life, whether it is your personal life, whether it is your professional life. So Virgo, if you have liked this reading, please like and subscribe. If you have something to say to me, write it in the comment box. People who are going through difficulties can contact me for a personal reading. These readings are prepaid, pre-booked and pre-slotted, so decide and then contact me. You can also book a reading for the next year, 2025, and I can provide you with an overall view of the year ahead, and you can request for that as well. So write to me through the email ID in the description box. Keep liking, sharing, commenting, and please do subscribe if you haven't. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.